Hello and welcome back to Everything Gaming, and in today's video I wanted to touch on the festival playlist, but there was a lot of questions raised specifically about qualifying for the online adventure, so I just want to touch on that as well. Now we'll start with that, and in essence it wants you to qualify for ranked, so it doesn't matter where you are on the ranked list, you just have to qualify either via the team racing, the team games or the free-for-all racing. Now I'm 9 out of 10 races in at the moment, as you can see, for the team racing, so obviously I'll do one more and then I'll get ranked from that. Now it doesn't matter if you're ranked in any of them, you can be ranked in one of the three, does not matter, and you will complete that final challenge. Now the best thing about that is it means you can win past prizes, so if you've completed all the main challenges and you only, for example, have the monthly rivals and the online ranked to complete, then if you complete both of them you'll win any past prizes you missed, but I'll get into that and I'll show you towards the end of the video. Now this ranked, trying to get ranked basically, isn't actually that hard or difficult, it's just a little bit time consuming because obviously you have to do 10 online adventures, either games or as teams or just on your own. But the best thing is it doesn't matter if you win or lose these adventures. Now obviously it's first to 3 wins out of 5 races, normally with 2 free roam rushes, so it's actually quite easy, like I said, to get ranked, because it doesn't matter what you finish in, whether it's first or last as a team or on your own, it really does not matter because each of them counts towards your basically out of 10 qualifying races to get ranked. Now the best thing about this, like I said, doesn't matter where you finish, but the annoying thing is obviously not many people like playing online, and I'm with you, mainly because of the actual people that race online. There's a lot of rammers even if they're on your own team, and there's a lot of people who just don't play fair, but luckily it doesn't matter too much unless you get really frustrated very fast, because like I said, it doesn't matter if you win or lose this, you'll still qualify for ranked after 10 of the online adventures, providing you don't quit or anything. Now as you can see, I completed that 10th adventure, and I got 50% on the overall festival playlist, not just for the season I was on, but overall, so I won the Ferrari F50 GT. Now if I complete all of the other challenges in winter and spring, I'll 100% that and unlock the Ford Capri. But as you can see here, in all the seasons, if you go to the far right, you'll see that it would have completed the monthly rivals and the online adventure, which puts you about 24% of the way in completing the next two seasons, being winter and spring. Now, I've only got 3% left in autumn, and that's because of the daily Forzathon challenges, where you get one a day sort of thing, hence why I've got 3% left, and that's 1% per Forzathon challenge. But the other thing you'll notice, as you can see here, is I've actually won the Porsche from the previous week's one, which is a summer competition, because obviously the only one I hadn't completed at that point was the online adventure, getting ranked to it. But now I have, and I've won the previous prize, so I thought I'd missed out, but actually I haven't. And because I've completed all in between the monthly rivals and the online ranked, obviously it meant that all I had to do was complete the two that take a month, and I'll win the previous challenges and prizes. So as you can see, it's not actually as difficult as you may think. It's just very, very time consuming. But if you complete all the challenges in between, you've got a whole month to complete those 10 online adventure races to qualify for ranked. So you can do one a day sort of thing. It doesn't matter, like I said, if you win or lose, just do one adventure a day, and then obviously you'll have completed the, you'll have got qualified, and you'll be in the ranked league, and obviously if you've done the monthly rivals as well, that's all good. So in the last month of spring, for example, if you haven't 100% of the previous three seasons, you can do so if all you had left to do is the rivals and the getting ranked for online. If you do them, you'll win all the past three prizes for 100% in that season, and of course you'll win the Ford Capri Forza edition. So the premise behind it is actually quite simple, and it's not that difficult at all. Like I said, it's just a bit time consuming, but you've still got 2.5 weeks basically to finish it off, so don't fear if you haven't completed those two yet, as you still have a chance of winning previous prizes. Anyway guys, I hope this has helped you out. If it has, please do drop a like and subscribe with hitting the bell icon for more videos just like this. If you have any comments, of which I'm sure some of you will, please do say so down below and I will get back to you as best as I can. But last of all, a massive thank you for everyone's support, and I hope this helped you out. All the best guys.